Alright, let's do this.
Years old in Texas, in Arlington, went to see the Rangers play the Mariners. The Mariners still had Alex Rodriguez, still had Ken Griffey Jr., still had Randy Johnson, Jay Buhner, Edgar Martinez. And I got to see Ken Griffey Jr. play center field. He hit like a bases clearing triple to take the lead late in the game, and then he robbed a home run to end the game. It was something special. It was a perfect high to have as a baseball fan, but as a kid, just watching your favorite players and some of the best at what they do go out there and really love it. I love baseball that much. That helped me get through school and figure out how to get good grades and pay attention enough in class to understand and pick up on things. And when it came to parties and things like that, I can't miss practice. I can't be getting in trouble. Can't be getting in trouble with the law. Can't have any DUIs, things like that, because I love baseball that much. I want to do what I saw when I was 9 years old, playing in that major league ballpark. I want a chance to do it. I don't know if I'm going to make it, but I want to give myself the best chance to do so. And I was so afraid that I wouldn't get a chance to live out a dream that I sacrificed for and that my parents sacrificed for. My parents, they laid a foundation as far as raising you, of course, and kind of making you in tune to living below your means when it comes to financial things or just treating people with respect and things like that. And I remember playing summer ball, junior Olympic teams in East Cobb in Georgia growing up in high school. And I played with some really good players. And guys that, some were drafted, some went on to play in the major league, some went on to be good college players, some didn't. We're not all gonna make it. But at times you would see them get bored with baseball and say, hey man, we're gonna go to this party, we're gonna do that. Like, man, we play for a great team right now. We have a great platform to get exposure to play against the best in the country, and I don't wanna waste that. Those decisions and those things that they allowed me to see at a young age, that sticks with me today. And when I have to make decisions on where I want to sign as a free agent, where I would like to live in the off season, whatever it is, who you're going to spend your time with, family, friends, what have you. It just starts at a young age for me. And I feel like it starts at a young age for all of us as far as the influences we gain. And then today for myself at an older age, I'm still 26, I'm still young, but I feel like I can make a pretty good educated decision on what I need for myself and my family going forward. Andrew Wilmot was a great teammate to me, but a great teammate to everybody, great friend. And Andy was just the kind of person that, he didn't have the most talent or anything like that when it came to being on the baseball field, but he was going to affect the game however he could. He brightened up a room whenever he came around, and you were always just happy to see him. He always had a grin on his face. He was always making people laugh. And when he passed away after his car accident, it hit everybody, it hit home for everybody. Of course, it hit home for me, but when it hits home on a ball club, like, that's family. It helped me get through it, knowing that it wasn't just me going through it alone. And a part of why I wear the number 22 is to give back to him and for his mom to have that. And his mom, their family, friends, everyone around, my teammates, the teammates that we share together. So it's just something that we can all do together and kind of fight it together, that sadness, and turn it into a positive. There's one piece of advice that I could pass on to the younger generation of America. It would be that just understand that nobody's perfect. Everything happens for a reason. We're human beings and we're gonna mess up, we're gonna make mistakes, but how you decide to go forward with that is what's gonna make the character in you. So what you do when nobody's looking, how you conduct yourself, whether it's on a baseball field, whether it's in a classroom, whether it's at work, whether it's at home with your parents, whether it's with your kids when you become a parent, all the above is just, how you overcome the tough times, because it's not gonna be easy. My name is Jason Hayward, right fielder for the Chicago Cubs. Baseball is my natural high. What's yours?
Good morning, Huskies. My name is Adrian.
And my name is Evan, recognizing this month's character trait, cooperation, and Red Ribbon.
Today is October 27th. Please stand for our nation's pledge.
Hey, what's up, Mr. Ray? Sorry I'm late.
It's okay, we're working on a group project. Deal with Josh. Go work on it.
Are you playing Fortnite?
Brennan, can you please work on the project? We're really behind.
Wait, we're actually behind on the project?
Yes!
Fine, I'll do it.
Okay!
Graveyard Gala will be taking place next Tuesday on Halloween from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. Today is the last day to purchase a ticket. Ticket price is $5, cash only, and you must show your school ID to purchase one. Tickets will not be sold after second lunch today. No exceptions.
The Dreadful Haunted Hallway will be an additional $2 to enter. You must have a dance wristband to participate in the hall. Grant music, carnival games where you can win prizes, and a cakewalk will be included with the purchase of your dance ticket. PTA will also be selling foods, drinks, and a variety of snacks at the event. Don't miss out on the scariest dance of the year, the Graveyard Gala. Again, today is your last day to buy a ticket.
Breakfast Club is still selling Halloween treat bags before school until October 31st. Prices are $3 for one bag or $5 for two bags.
Today is the last day of Red Ribbon Week. Hopefully you wore the craziest hat to put a cap on drugs. Remember, Huskies, to take off your hat before you arrive to class.
Attention 8th grade East Coast tour travelers. Your very first mandatory student meeting will take place Wednesday, November 8th in room 104 directly after school. All student tour travelers must attend. These meetings are mandatory if you want to go on the tour. You must be there. And if you want to know who is all going on the trip, there are posted rosters in the 200 squad. See Ms. Farias or Mr. Russo regarding any tour questions or concerns.
Come on down to today's Friday activity, Hockey Shootout. Make one or two shots, get one prize. Make all three shots, get two prizes. Look forward to seeing you there.
Now let's go to Mr. Jomkowski one more time regarding Halloween costume protocol.
Good morning, Hillsdale Huskies. Mr. Jomkowski here to talk to you a little bit about Halloween. This year, Halloween lands on Tuesday, which is a school day, of course, and we expect a lot of students will be coming to school dressed in their Halloween costumes. But I want to go over some expectations we have regarding dressing up and wearing costumes at school. First of all, your Halloween costume should follow dress code. We want to make sure that Halloween costumes are not that revealing, so make sure that you look at the student handbook and check out the dress code policy to make sure that your Halloween costume fits within dress code. One small difference when it comes to dress code and Halloween costumes, you will be able to wear hats at Hillsdale Middle School on Halloween that are not Hillsdale hats. So if it's a costume or a part of your costume is a hat, like a witch's hat or a cowboy hat or something along those lines, you're welcome to wear that in class or at school. Just remember that your teacher might ask you to take the hat off in class if it is too much of a distraction or blocks the view of other students. Face painting and masks. Masks will not be tolerated on Halloween at Hillsdale Middle School. We need to be able to see your face and identify who you are. So please don't bring a mask as a part of your costume to Halloween at Hillsdale Middle School. Face painting and makeup will be allowed, but as long as it's less than 25% of your face that's covered. We want to make sure that students are identifiable, so face painting is tolerated, but make sure that it's not overboard. Talk to your math teachers about what 25% of your face painted might look like, and then they can clear that up for you. Lastly, we want to make sure that props and fake weapons and fake blood and all that stuff that might scare people here or make people feel uncomfortable is left at home. Anything that looks like a weapon or any kind of prop that looks dangerous will have to be left at home or it will be confiscated by the administration, and you'll have to take it home later on after the school day is over. Thank you, everybody, for following these expectations on Halloween. We're really looking forward to a great day. You're going to be really excited to see the haunted hallway and have fun at the Halloween gala. So I'm looking forward to that, too. Everybody, have a great day today, and I'll see you around.